Hello, everyone. Today, I'm at the Celebrity Connected AMA's Gifting Suite with
Agnes Mo.
And this is On the Spot Interviews. Hello, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing great as well. These events are always so fun. Have you been before?
Yeah, I think a few years ago.
Oh, so it's been a while.
What do you have planned for 2018?
2018, possibly touring, and I'm flying out to New York again for some performances there. And I'm going to do a little something with folk as well, so that's, you know, all of them are.
Now, you're not from the U.S., so do you do anything with Thanksgiving on Thursday? Will you be celebrating somehow?
You know what? This year would be my second Thanksgiving. So it's going to be interesting just because, like, I'm not really familiar with the culture. Again, which is exciting, because then I get to know, like, oh, this is what you do. Eat good food, I'm there.
And then you're going to sleep right after.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Thank you so much, Agnes. Appreciate it. Have fun tonight.
So, you know, exciting to work with some of the dopest producers, Grammy Award-winning producers and songwriters, who happen to be my closest friends as well. You know, it's just, you know, it's the same family. Keep it in the family. Keep it authentic. Keep it real.
I guess I was here in 2010, if I'm not mistaken, as one of the co-hosts of the Red Carpet of American Music Awards. And now I'm here walking down the red carpet and, you know, talking to you. This is amazing.
And so I know, of course, you have your music, but I also heard you're very much into directing your music videos and the creative. Tell me a little bit about that. How do you get in? What inspires you?
Well, I think, you know, when I write my music in the studio and when I record my songs, I already kind of envision what the visual needs to be. And so that's why I love to produce my own vocal. I like to direct my music videos just because I feel like the fans need to really know the real me, and it needs to be authentic. It needs to come from an honest place. And I don't mind working or collaborating with people. I just feel like it's so much easier to just do it, especially if you've done that before. They can believe in my craft. I have to believe in my craft first, and I think that's what I'm doing.
100%. I love that. You definitely have a vision when you create a song. You want to execute it through the video.
Yeah.
So now I want to ask you, as a female artist, I feel like it's much different for males and females in this music game. And I actually noticed that a lot of females aren't really up for any awards aside from, you know, their gender-specific categories. Why do you think that is?
Well, you know, I think we all know that women, we kind of have to fight our battle twice as hard, if not three times harder. You know, even like the fashion itself, like there's just like a lot of things going on in our world, and especially in the industry, we all know, like, whatever's going on behind the curtains, like, people, you know, think that it's okay to do this and do that to female artists. And, you know, I think for me, it's just super important to, you know, just put my foot down. and know the boundaries and focusing on the music. Because to be honest, like negative thoughts like that would have, you know what I mean, like would have made me not focus on the things that I should have focused on. And just, you know, making sure that I have the right inner circle, I have the right people to protect me. You know, walking into the studio knowing their credibility and knowing exactly if they want to be in the studio because of your music or it's because of something else. And I think it's hard for some people to notice or to know, especially because this entertainment business is hard, you know? Like, people sometimes, they think that it's okay to do more than what it takes when it's actually, it doesn't have to go that way. Like what I said, it's so important for me to have my inner circle, the right team, the right people who actually believe in my ability as a musician, as a singer, and not just me as a woman. Exactly.
There's more than just the face and the body. There's talent behind it.
Absolutely. And again, I'm just super happy the fact that I think female artists, women, can make it to this point right now because we're not afraid. We're not afraid to put in double the work. We're not afraid to actually say, hey, this needs to be about my music and not just the pretty face and the body.
I love it. You're so passionate about it. That's amazing. So before you move on, I want to ask you, so I know you have your music in the works, but I also heard you had a little something else coming down the pipeline involving fashion and a magazine.
So I went to New York.
Here, but
I'm in New York for T-Isles, and then I also went there to meet with Vogue, and there's gonna be something exciting coming up with Vogue, and we're gonna do that in the beginning of December, but then I think the fans will want to do something, and we'll see the result or the outcome of that around March, but I can't really say anything else, but... October. It's called X, or it's actually 10, but it's the Roman numeral of 10X. And I'm just super happy the fact that I think this album has been the most authentic and the most honest album I've ever put out. Again, because I've worked with some of the dopest producers who happen to be my closest friends as well. They're like Grammy Award winning producers, but the work ethic is just, you know, about the music. They're about, you know, my craft. You know, so yeah. I mean, it's just, you know, exciting. Danger Nate Hills is one of the producers. Jim Beans is also one of the producers. I mean, as we all know, Danger is, you know, responsible for Justin Timberlake's 2020 album, and you know what I mean. From Jim Beans, from Nella Furtado to Jennifer Hudson. So, you know, like working with them as friends and also as musicians